Hello, my sock universe, to an unexpected video, but I'm mad and I need to vent my madness. If you just have seen what was happening yesterday, Austria lost again 5-2 in Israel. And it was already the Euro qualifiers that they lost 4-2 in Israel. And this should never have happened in any way this way. And it makes me just so mad. All the credit that this Austrian team got, at least around here, for playing well against Ukraine, finally showing what they are capable of doing, playing really well against Italy, especially in the second half when they said to Foda, you know, we can play a certain way, let's do it, let's go all out instead of just hang back and losing. All that, gone, within two matches. And I already knew I'm not gonna watch the Moldavia game because there were other more interesting games for me to watch that day, but also because I knew this is gonna be a really, really bad watch. But I was kind of looking forward. Maybe they will show us something against Israel. Maybe. And to be fair, I mean, you really, in order to have any judgment of this game, and I urge you, before maybe you even continue with this video, look for some highlights of this game, because I am not kidding you. Even at 3-0 down, I honestly had the feeling that Austria, if they can fix their problems in playing defensively and, you know, staying together, staying as a team, and not that we have an attack in front and a defense in back and there's nothing in between and nobody needs to backtrack. If that, and this should be an easy fix, if that could have been fixed, they tried. I had a feeling that they can win this game. That they absolutely can win this game, because this was a freak result. Israel, in the first half, had 3 shots on goal. 3 goals. They had a 4th shot, which was the 4th goal, and I think they may have had some in between, but the statistics of the game were something absolutely ridiculously lopsided in favor, actually, of Austria in many ways. So this is what even more angers me, that now this is used as an excuse when honestly it should not be, because it is again, and what angers me more, that, you know, I would have forgiven the whatever was happening yesterday was inexcusable on so many levels. Inexcusable, because you could see all the weaknesses of Austria on the play, but you also saw a little bit of the strength on display. Just to draw the scene, I mean, I was looking now for the stats. Goal attempts 19-9, shots on goal 7-7, but this was then lopsided towards the end. It was a ridiculous game where Israel was outrageously effective. However, Austria played their part in that big time. Now, to start off, I think I want to give now all the excuses that we can give to Austria before I really need to rip further apart. First excuse. Yes, there were players missing, especially Sabitzer, who just made a move to Bayern, and also Stefan Leiner, who are good players. But to be honest, we have replaced players like this before. This squad is deep. Yes, we'll talk about the squad in just a sec. This squad is deep. Every position can be replaced in there. This is the level that Austria has gotten in between. So, but yeah, okay, I give him Sabitzer, I give him Leiner. With those, maybe the team is even a little bit better. The other excuse is that the way this international break is made is just absolutely ridiculous. You have basically a travel day, you have a training session, you have a match. Travel day, training session, match. So there's not much preparation to work on. So what would you do as a good coach in this? Well, how about going for the tried and tested? No. We play against Moldavia in a system that maybe it was before, but everyone knew, yeah, okay, let's get an easy win. And it was a horrible watch. From the little bit that I saw, it was you could not see it. Even the Austrian commentator, who so far was always more on Foda's side, he just refused to commentate this anymore because it's a team that you just need to get away. But what's even worse is that against Israel, Austria ahead of this game was, I think, number 23 in the world ranking, and Israel, I wanna say, is 86. Let me double check this here. But somewhere 81st. They talked up that opponent that it is not an opponent where you just go there and say you can win. No, we have Zahavi up front. Talk about him in a sec as well. We have Zahavi up front. They have a very good opponent. Like, they cause us problems. This is a very, very tough opponent. Same thing with Moldova. Yeah, they are down there, but we cannot ignore them. You know, talking up opponents that are clearly worse than you are. And I would say it's okay if you're a pundit to kind of, okay, put it in perspective. But as a team, you have a certain status that you have to say we go there and we beat them. And we can beat the crap out of them because they're clearly inferior opponent. We know all their weaknesses. So, what does a good coach do when you have such a short time? Go to the try and test it. No, we're talking up the opponent. We're mirroring the lineup of Israel with a back three that has never worked. And boy, did it not work this time around. You can see that the players are not comfortable there. Now, to the positive again. Austria pressed, knew that the defense of the Israeli, and Israel is maybe a very extreme team that is super potent up front and an absolute shambles on the back. And you could see this already. I mean, if you watch the game, just watch the first 10 minutes, if you have the chance. Austria is always attacking early, is pressing them. The problem is they only press with two men and then there's not the backup. And this is what killed them. And this is where I pull it on Foda that he probably said, okay, we need to hang back and we, you know, keep the defensive shape, blah, 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 blah. But the players instinctively know that if we press them, we can get a whole lot of things out of them. And they pressed them and they got in positions. But then that's the next thing, the attitude. And I have to single out especially Arnautovic, who I hate to single out because Arnautovic has been carrying this national team, maybe not over the past 2 years, but I think from the Euro 2016 up until like 2019, he has been carrying this team on his shoulders. So there's a lot of credit to it. But the way he showed yesterday, horrible first touches. And you know, this kind of, I know that I'm good and against you guys, it's so easy to score. Yes, he got a goal, but it was too late. He should have had at least one goal before that. He hit the post once, but off that, there were enough chances where you just gotta put the ball on goal and not think with an easy shot you can go in there, because the Israeli defense was a shambles. This was the worst defending I've ever seen. However, they only give two goals, whereas Austria give up five. Because what was happening with Austria is that they get caught on a counter contract. Again, they don't double up. The first goal comes because Grilic outside? Solomon, arguably a really good player for Israel and the most well player, he just makes a wiggle, is past him. But if there is someone else up there to back him up, like then this is not going to happen. He can make a cross in. No, it's not a cross, it's a shot. It's a wonderful goal. The second one, the way they forget Dabur because they are not backtracking. And the third one was an individual mistake that just fit in the picture. Yes, a little bit unlucky. You had a goal disallowed. It was a handball, but you should have made that goal anyway before that. You need to put the ball on the net and not try to find another position. A little bit more and not try to show your superiority. This was just from every angle a wrong way of going about things. And what angers me is that we had the same showing in early 2019, where we even had a 1-0 lead, where we also thought, yeah, we can easily beat the Israeli, and then we lose 4-2. So there was a warning under the same coach with literally the same core that you cannot find a way. And I really blame Foda for, again, tinkering with a system where there was no need to tinker. We knew what worked well. We knew it worked well against Ukraine, and it worked actually pretty well against Italy for at least one half. Why do you talk up the opponent? And then why is Israel such a bogey team at the moment? Because the former Austrian sporting director is now their head coach. First, he got Andreas Herzog, who had a field day against Austria, winning that one. And then now he is himself the coach. And he knows he has a weak defense, but he also knows how to catch out Foda quite well. And with a Zahavi up front, and a Dabur and a Weissmann, and this is the other galling thing is, Austrians know Dabur and Weissmann. They played in the Austrian league. We know them, everything about them. This is not a surprise. We should not even be surprised about Zahavi. Because now here comes the super stat. Zahavi has now scored 6 goals in 3 games against Austria. There's only one player that has scored more goals against Austria, and that is Ferenc Puskás. And there's another one who scored 6 goals, Miroslav Klose, in 5 games. And Ferenc Puskás and Miroslav Klose, I mean, it's Puskás, Klose, Zahavi. Zahavi is a great player, but how do you make this player even stronger than it needs to be? I saw him with PSV against Benfica. Yes, he was the attacking threat, but he missed big chances. He is not a superstar. Yes, he's probably a better striker than whatever we have in the Austrian national team. However, as a team, Israel is a joke in many ways. And you talk to, and you make this opponent strong. Just to give you an idea, I really want to give Israel a lot of credit because they did exactly what they had to do. Minus the horrible defending, which, I mean, that backline, the way this was, what they were doing was just ridiculous. They had the ball. There's just one Austrian pressing, they lose the ball again, and then Austria cannot capitalize from this. I mean, this is the incredible stuff. And then they think it is easy, they're not backtracking, and then you get caught out because, again, the offensive power of Israel is good. However, just to show you the difference between the Austrian squads, I'm just rattling off a few clubs that the players are playing. Most of the Israeli team, especially in defense, is playing in the Israeli league. For Maccabi Tel Aviv, Hapoel Be'er Sheva, Beitar Yerushalayim, Maccabi Haifa. So you get the, there is one playing for Vitesse. The backup goalie who played yesterday is playing for Feyenoord, who has not played a thing. He's the backup goalie there. And then we have players. I mean, Solomon, who is the big talent, is playing for Shakhtar Donetsk, which is probably the second biggest team in there, because then there's PSV Eindhoven. Yeah, Real Valladolid for Sean Weissmann. Yeah, PSV Eindhoven is better. But you see kind of, there's also one playing for Venezia, Sporting Kansas City is in there. Now, the Austrian team, the national team players, I mean, it's more or less a German Bundesliga All-Star 11. Admittedly, Eintracht, it's teams like Eintracht Frankfurt, Union Berlin, Hoffenheim, Köln, there are some Leipzig players. Now we have one, Bayern Munich. However, the others, I mean, we have the goalie at Watford, and then it comes. We have one player at Real Madrid, we have one player at Barcelona. And I know these teams are not great at the moment, but just rattling off these names, there is a clear gulf in quality. And you can tell it just by the teams that it's coming from. The problem is that the coach that we have is a very small-minded coach who had success with a team with a small-minded philosophy, with Sturm Graz. But he has not had any other big thing. Everywhere else, I think he has failed. It is an absolute mess. It's an absolute disgrace that this generation of Austrian players, I don't want to say world class, but the step below, number 23 in the world ranking, is probably quite accurate. This is a team that should have no problem qualifying for any World Cup, to be honest, at this moment. I would put them definitely in the top 15 in Europe by potential. and there's no light inside. It is just galling to the highest degree. I honestly would not be surprised if many players, I don't think they have the guts to do it, but I think many players just say, I don't want to play for the national team anymore. It is that bad. It is that bad. The one positive thing is, and I was very surprised about the Austrian TV broadcast yesterday, because I actually, by just a glimpse, I thought, yeah, maybe let's watch it on Austria, let's give it a chance. They were highly critical, and this has never happened before. And so a team that after the Euros was maybe not rightfully so, but you know, people felt good about it. All the credit is gone. All the credit is gone. And so you find yourself now in fourth position. Second place is already, if you look expected standings, second place already quite a stretch. Although Israel is not that good. And I don't see them do anything good against Scotland either. This is just downbeat. I am dejected. Absolutely dejected. I will do more on the European qualifiers tomorrow when everything else was played. But I knew this will be gonna be a rant of Israel and Israel and Austria, and I want to get it in a separate video. I'm really, really mad. And all these excuses that are put up front, to me, they're all exactly that, excuses. There is a deeper problem. And if Foda then comes out and says, it's not the system that is the problem. It is that we didn't convert our chances. This is the easiest excuse out there. If he was a true man, he would go out there, yes, this is on me. No, he's never going to do it. He's one of those that if he wins, it's all about him. And yeah, maybe we, the players, did well. But when they lose, it's all the player not executing and making mistakes. Instead of seeing his own problems. So yeah. I'm not going to watch Austria for a long time. It's not worth it. I'm going to look for other teams. It is not worth it. The anger in me is not worth it. In any case, give me a thumbs up if you like, enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos. Hopefully not many like these. And I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey, just in case you enjoyed this video, here are some videos and playlists that you actually might enjoy too. Also, please consider following me on social media and actually subscribe to my channel so that you stay up to date with everything that happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day. Bye.